Hey YouTubers, Xander here, welcome back to Subnautica. Last time, the entire world collapsed around us as the issues with the inactive lava biome decided to, spread is an interesting way of putting it, but basically it confined us to a single block around our base. So, yeah, I made the decision that since I couldn't fix the problem, the game was basically unplayable around that point, that I would uninstall the game and reinstall it. Well, I made a discovery upon doing that. It deletes all your save files, and I didn't back them up. So regardless of whether I wanted to or not, I'm starting a new file. And it's a bit sad because all my old ones have also disappeared as well. Even ones that were well outdated months ago that I was just keeping for nostalgic purposes. So yeah, we're gonna have to hop into a new file of survival. But this time, we're gonna make it a little bit more challenging. I've decided to implement a self-restriction where I can only acquire food through knife purposes. So I can't use the fabricator. I can't use plants unless I can't grow plants, things like that. So we'll only be able to use a knife. So, let's see how it goes.
Detecting increased local radiation levels. Greetings, survivor. Great job not dying. To assist you in further survival in emergency situations, you have been issued this personal data assistant. The interface visible now will organize your inventory, display currently available construction blueprints, and holds other valuable information. Please take a moment to familiarize yourself with it.
Already getting this one? That's not good. Alright, so I guess we'll use these as well. But other than that, pretty much anything food-wise we'll have to get with our knife. Which obviously will be helpful later on when we can get the thermal blade, but until then, it's gonna be interesting. Be using plenty of the kelp forest, so that's a thing. Oh, you know what I never got to do? I didn't get to try to acquire, get back to the life pod in the old file. I didn't get to do that. Oops. Oh, seems like they changed that. That's interesting.
Okay. Caution. Continued degradation of the Aurora's dry core may cause a quantum detonation. calculating risk assessment. Death by malnourishment, 7%. By physical injury, 11%. By exposure to radioactive crash site materials, 19%. If the drive core is breached, probability of death increases to 65%.
Well, right now I'm very much dealing with that 11%.
Acquired.
Jeez, bleeders too.
Oxygen.
I really like that change. Just that little beep to say oxygen instead of having to deal with the 30 seconds of oxygen remaining. Blah, 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 blah. It's cool. Let's see. Gonna need that. Please let me be able to make another one. Nice. So there we go. Boom. Okay, so what else can I do with all this titanium?
Warning, local radiation readings exhibit characteristics consistent with total degradation of the Aurora's dark matter drive core. A quantum detonation will occur with a probability of 85.5%. Advise observing a 1 kilometer safety range.
Ah, that. I was like, what's making that noise? Alright, we'll throw this in here. We need to start making batteries so we can work on the scanner and whatnot. For now, let's pull out our trusty blade. I would love and laugh if that, like, slashing animation actually managed to, like, hit something. Okay. Let's head on out. See if we can get some copper real quick. Nice. We are in quite an open area. Alright, so let's see.
Emergency. Seismic readings suggest a quantum detonation.
Are you kidding me?
Drive core. The central dark matter reactor will reach a supercritical state in T minus 10. 9, 8, 7, 6,
like,
5,
we're only 10 minutes 4, in. Not even 10 3, minutes in. 2. Holy crap. That is gotta be the... did I really just take fall damage from that? Alright, whatever. That's gotta be the fastest death explosion I think I've ever seen. Okay. So we're on a bit of a time crunch, because right now the only thing nearby that I can use as a source of food... Well, I mean, I guess I could eat... I guess I could eat fish raw, but I'm pretty sure that would just lower stuff. Okay, I can't really do it on that. Scanner, I need titanium. Do I want to build anything else right now? Okay, probably not. Let's start getting our scanning going on. So So I believe they've changed how certain stuff appears fragment-wise. So in theory, we should be able to start getting stuff sooner. In theory. Alright, we're gonna start scanning everything though, and that's gonna suck. See, let's just catch this. Yeah, so it'll give me food, but not water. So basically, stuff that I can only, I don't know. I guess grabbing fish with my bare hands is alright. But I can't cook them at the fabricator. So, yeah, we'll see how that goes. I need to scan you just so I can distinguish between limestone and sandstone chunks. And then smash. Okay. So I guess the next spot I should be looking for. Trying to figure out where I am. Relation to the environment. So let's see. Oh god. Well, there's a sand shark right there, but it's possible that there's other blueprints hidden away around here. Looks of it, no. I believe life pot 6 is this way, so we'll swing by there, grab our radiation suit. Spot in the dark. Let's see. That's good. Look at that mobile vehicle bay just like that. Oh, almost. Look at that, didn't even need to go inside the wreck. So that brings up the question of what is inside the wreck. Well, we have a PDA, we can't get in there because we'd have to repair. Wait, hang on. Oh. Oh, hello, there's a box right there. Oh, well, that's not good. That's not useful, I should say. I mean, it's good, but not useful. Alright. So we already have the mobile vehicle bay.
Oxygen.
And here's life pod 6. Which means radiation helmet. And in PDA.
Integrating new
radiation PDA. Gloves. And radiation suit. And just like that, before even experiencing it in the slightest, radiation is not an issue. Again, something I don't entirely agree with, but whatever. I just did it, so I have to agree with it, right? So now we need to look for some form of kelp forest so I can try and get some more food. Grab some salt while I'm at it, now that I think about it. Go for a repair kit. So I can find a crash. Get that crash powder. There's one. Thank you. See, that wasn't so bad. Now I just need to find some more salt. Just in time for the sun to come out. The sun will come out tomorrow. But you're bottom on it. So now we need to be looking for a sea glob. Interesting. Speak of the devil. Alright, I'm okay with that. So let's see. Pull out the knife, grab some more. I'm only gonna grab four at a time because I know excessive amounts causes you to puke, and then that'll just basically waste all the efforts. Okay. That's gold, that's salt, that's lead.
Oxygen.
I need oxygen. Huh, interesting, no gasps for air. Okay, I see this right here, which leads me to believe there is in fact... Ouch. Alright, that was worth... Let's see... More copper... Ooh, hello, Stalker Tooth. That's bleeders. I should probably get out of here since I'm only at half health. Ah, crud. Just going in the wrong direction for the life pod. Let's use that just in case. Need to quickly... Risk it. Let's go for three more and see what happens with that. Alright, it worked. Cool. I don't need more titanium at the moment. Oh, that's bad. That's gonna hurt. Oh! Or not. I'm okay with dodging it. Okay. So now we can make the repair tool, and potentially, oh, no, we won't be able to make the sea glide, huh? Oh. Okay, let's make one of those. Make one of those. Make that. Okay. Let's get the ship repaired. Or life pod, I should say. It's not exactly a ship. Waterborne, oh, waterborne bacteria levels high. Interesting.
9 hours.
I have a feeling I'm gonna need to grab these. So let's see. Okay, fine. Life pod 4, okay. Can't take another risk and see. Holy crap, that is a pile of scraps. Nice, got some silver. Got some more silver. Okay, I know I saw a tooth. That's what I saw. And there is a tooth. Perfect. Ooh, you are infected.
Oxygen remaining.
Oh, what? So you still do the 30-second warning? So what, it can't decide between whether it wants to give me the oxygen warning or the actual countdown? Interesting. So the problem with kelp finds is that they only give me 1%. Which is pretty bad. Oh, hang on a moment. Life pod 17 mentioned that the... So that's the one we want to head to. Because that's the one that it just said the forward... Oh, yes. Okay, so that's the one in the... grassy plateau that's right next to a wreckage, and that wreckage says is the forward part of the sea moth bay, meaning that there will be sea moth fragments there. I like that. Alright, so. Alright, guess I'm using these already. Titanium. Alright, already building a sea moth, or sea glide. Okay. We'll throw all those in there. What did I want a computer chip for? The builder, alright. Son of a bitch! Stop it! Life pod 6. Haha, too late. Okay. So now what I need is copper. I need to find one of the tunnels, the coral tunnels filled to the brim. Oh, duh, right here, perfect. Is that another sea glide thing? Interesting. Alright, so they made sea glides easier to get the blueprints for. I'm okay with that. Still need a little bit more copper. Maybe two more. There's one more. Two more. Perfect. Okay. That'll be enough for 5 batteries. One can go towards building the builder. One was going to go towards something. What else was it? I don't know. I forgot already. Okay. I know I wanted to have like 3 spares, because from here I'm going probably straight to the island. I don't care about a flashlight. I do care about the builder. Work quickly. Two computer chips. One builder. One just as a spare. Oh, this one could be a thermometer, but I don't care for that. Okay. Those. All right, blueprints. Foundation takes 4 to... All right. Son of a... Why is it always as I'm about to leave my god dang light bomb? Motherfucking Freddy Banner. Light bomb 7, yeah, I don't... We're plugging some holes in our emergency sea line. Oh. I don't care about light pod 7. I don't even think I care about one of the other ones. What is it, 6? Yeah, I really don't care about that. 17, I do care about. Alright. Oh. I don't know where to build my base. Hmm. could do what I did in the past and just build it in the grassy plateau. That's an option. Only problem with that is, woof, be far away from the kelp forest, which, you're gonna attack me. You're a not so nice one. Doesn't this area look familiar? Wow, is it dark? Why is it so dark? Like, actually kind of creepy how dark it is right now. And then suddenly not. What the hell? And has the shape of the island changed? I don't remember this being here. Cool. Bubble trees for water. Creep vines for food. Until I get my thermal blade at least. That's gonna have to do. But now I'm wondering, do I allow myself to grow bulbo trees? Where's this? This is what leads to the teleport room? Oh, no, okay. I was like, wait, isn't the teleporter like higher up? Oh shit, fall damage. Okay, I remember that. That's a creepy tree. Oh, there's the normal entrance. Okay. Curse splash. Why is it bright in here? Like, I was bright down here, but out here it's like, nope, pitch black. Screw you, you can't see anything. Not allowed. Alright. Let's get those blueprints. Question is, do I allow myself to use? No, because that's just too easy. I need that risk factor. Wasn't expecting a purple artifact. Oh, you're infected with Karar too. Damn. Okay, now I need to get out of here. Okay. Alright, you know what? Yeah, you're gonna have to die. Alright, not sure where he went, but okay. Nice battery. Bulkhead. The usual stuff. So everything from this one, I believe. And I guess I will scan the exterior grow bed, but I'm probably not going to use them. So what's the point of a challenge if I'm just easily able to acquire food? So basically, I think this challenge will consist of me having to make frequent trips here, just so I can use the bulbo trees for water. So pretty. Sounds are new. Interesting. Huh? Oh, that's... Oh. I always love the sounds of, like, rocks falling down a hill or a mountain. Sir, you're not even in your thing. What are you doing? I don't think this is supposed to be here, but I'm not going to complain. King in the mountain. Yeah, just looking out. You know, you obviously can't see what's under the water still. I love this game. Okay. I did just scan the interior grow bed, didn't I? Maybe I show at the top now. Yeah. So I guess the last thing to find would be the teleporter room? But I mean, do I actually have to? Does it matter? No, I can't use it because the only way to open it is from the... Ah, here it is. Well, I guess I'm going to find it anyways. Oh. Interesting. Yeah, I can't activate that from this end. It has to be activated from the other end. Which basically means I should head over there soon. Oh. It's like the island actually slowly collapsing or something like that. Let's head back. Start working on some form of a base now. Grab some kelp vines on the way for food. Ooh, hey, lithium. Almost wondering.
30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Would this be a good spot to set up a base? I mean, if we think about it, right here, we're on like the edge of Grand Reef, the Sparse Reef, Kelp Forest, Grassy Plateau. It's on the border of four different biomes. It's near the island for water.
Caution, calorie deficiency detected.
That's why I'm here.
Vital signs stabilizing.
Hope I can eat one more. All right, I can.
Caution, 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Interesting. Whoa. Go out and grab quartz for glass. Hello. Don't know why I was thinking about that. I'm like, what am I trying to even build? I forgot. Okay, let's see. Wiring kit. Alright, that's gonna be problematic. So I'll be able to make two. But I need silver. Now let's throw as much of this as I can back. I'm gonna go out and look for silver. So I need two in order to make a fabricator. Ouch. Alright, you got me. Congrats. You must feel so proud of yourself. What's that? Oh, lab equipment. Oh, it's an eclipse. It's like, why is it getting suddenly super dark? So cool to see. My knife's already at half durability. Okay. Need to be on the lookout for sandstone? Nope. Very close.
Caution, 30 seconds of oxygen
to the
remaining.
And that is bad. I'm actually like scarily close to the wreck. Neat. Sandstone? Oh, come on. Where's the guy gotta go to get some sandstone? That's some gold. God dang it. Already wishing I had a freaking scanner room.
Caution. 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Really? More gold? Just gonna keep spitting gold out at me. jerks. Holy crap, that's a surface dwelling reef bag. What the fuck? That's limestone. Come on. There we go, there's one. More limestone.
Seconds of oxygen remaining.
Yes, I get. Alright, you know what? I just need to, like, fucking scan the creep vines, or stop bugging me about it. Oh, fuck off, bleeder.
Oxygen.
Found it. Alright. Oh, come on. One more sandstone. That's all I need. There it is. All right, cool. So the question still remains, do I build in that junction between those four biomes? I think I do. Okay. And I think another good reason for having the base out here is just because it'll be extremely easy to orient myself, since I'll be right where
Caution, 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
I enter the debrief normally. Cause they're right down there. Okay. Oh, just because I just built the thing. I think this is actually a good angle, too, because that's the normal angle, almost, to how I build them. Power. There. More power.
Power restored. All primary systems online. Welcome aboard, Captain.
Locker.
Caution. Blood nutrient levels decreasing. Calorie intake recommended.
I didn't grab the computer chip. Son of a bitch. Alright. Wow, this is actually really cool. I did bring a nutrient block, okay.
Vital signs stabilizing.
Just gonna use them now. Oh, look at that. This would have been cooler to build on top of this thing. Oh, it would have been so much cooler to build on top of this thing. But I like the spot I'm at. I think it'll be good. Because we can build an observatory directly above the Grand Reef, and it'll be nice, and ooh, getting excited. Excited. Can't believe I forgot the computer chip, though. More gold. I don't even have power transmitter yet, so that gold is pretty much useless. Let me just empty this out. Almost. That aspect. Okay. Another freaking eclipse? Holy crap. Question is it beginning or ending? Or it looks like it's ending, so that's good. Alright, I need to find another copper on the way. Because I'd like to build a beacon. It's titanium. There we go. And I can grab two quartz. Wait, what? Oh, life pod 6. I was like, wait, it can't be built at my base, right? That doesn't make sense. So I can build a beacon, build one more solar panel, build the fabricator. Not be able to build that. Oh wow, look at that. Oh, that's cool. Just look at it just standing out here on top of this ledge. It looks so cute. Turn through here. Finish that off. What else did I want to build? Oh, yes, the beacon. I was thinking it was something with the builder, not the fabricator that I needed to finish. Here we are. Out here, set this to one. Directly underneath, ta-da! No! Damn it! Okay. Home. Ah. All right. Let's see here. This shortly. In fact, I'll just do that now. Okay. So let's see. I think we're in a good area. Like where we are, it's very orientable. I guess if that's not the right word, whatever. I don't know, I like it. It has a much more home feel than the base I made in the last file. This is good. So I guess in the next episode, we'll go grab the sea moth fragments if we can get, we'll have to get a pipe network going. So we'll make pipes so we can get to Life Pod 17 and get a sea moth going. But yeah, this is interesting. Like, right now we've been using the nutrient blocks and the water that we just happened to find or we have in our pod to start us out with, but I think we're all out of that, aren't we? Like, yeah, we only have one more nutrient block. After that, it's bulbo trees and kelp creep vines until we can get the thermal blade. So we need to work fast. Yeah, I kind of like it. A little bit of a time crunch. You can figure out ways to either help this challenge, that'd be like some sort of way of acquiring food or water through a knife or potentially by hand or something. I don't know, just thoughts on the challenge as a whole. I'd greatly appreciate it, but yeah, hope you guys enjoyed, and I guess I'll see you next time.